everyone, welcome to day 19 of the holiday card series. I'm going to be using this stamp set today. It's from Hero Arts and Studio Calico, and I'm going to stamp the circle border stamp from the stamp set on some old olive cardstock from Stampin' Up. I want it to be tone on tone, so I'm also using old olive ink. I'm going to be stamping the circle border repeatedly all over this piece of cardstock. This cardstock is cut to a standard size card, so it's 5.5 wide by 4.25 tall. And I'm not going to be using this entire piece of cardstock, but I figured I might as well stamp the entire thing, and then I'll have extra pieces that I can use on other cards later. Just seemed more efficient to do it that way. So after I stamped the green piece, I punched out 3 squares out of Nina Solar White cardstock. I used a 1 3/8 square punch, and I'm going to be stamping the 2 Christmas trees from the stamp set on these 3 squares. I'm using Garden Green ink and Old Olive ink from Stampin' Up, just 2 of my favorite green colors for the holidays. And I'm just stamping the trees in different arrangements on all 3 squares. I wanted them to look a little bit different from each other. After I had them stamped, I cut out a strip of cherry cobbler cardstock from Stampin' Up, and I think it's about 1.5 inch wide strip, and I'm just punching out the end with this postage stamp edge punch from EK Success. I also used my corner chomper, just the 1/4 inch rounder, and punched out 2 opposite corners on each square. Gives them a kind of a really mod kind of 1960s vibe. I thought it was kind of cool. And then I adhered those to the red strip of cardstock with some foam adhesive. So you put those down, and then I trimmed it down so that it was just slightly, you know, like around the end on that side. After that, I cut down the green piece so that it was not so wide. I kept the height so it was still 4.25 tall, however. And now I brought in my card base. I decided to use Nina Desert Storm environmental cardstock for the card base because it's just a great brown color. I'm using the Hero Arts designer wood grain stamp for the background. And you'll notice that I don't put it completely on the background stamp. I'm having that one end hang off. And that's because I wanted to have a little bit of blank area left on the card front. I think it becomes its own little design element when you leave some of it blank, and then you can arrange things on top. So when I lifted it off, I had that one side open. Looks a little bit strange now, but once I put everything on it, it'll look better. I'm using the Happy Holidays sentiment from the same stamp set, and I'm going to be embossing. So I'm using my EK Success Patter Tool in the bottom corner of this chocolate chip cardstock from Stampin' Up. And then I ended up stamping the sentiment twice in Versamark. The first time was a little tiny bit crooked, and I wanted it to be straight just so it would be easier to cut. So I ended up stamping it twice. I applied some white embossing powder, and then I heat set it. And then I trimmed it out and used my scissors to cut some little ribbon ends on each end. So now I'm going to start assembling the card. I first adhered down the green piece of cardstock, and I'm really loving the Glue Glider Pro. I think of all the different adhesives that I've tested out over the last few months, I think it's my favorite. I've tried both the Hi-Tech and the Permatech, and I've really liked both. So I adhered the tree piece with some foam adhesive, and then I went ahead and did foam adhesive on the back of the sentiment piece as well. There was a little bit of space underneath the Happy Holidays, and so I decided to use my white gel pen and just put a little dash line. I didn't mean for there to be a spot. I hadn't planned it, but since there was, I decided to go ahead and take advantage of it by putting those dash lines. So then I rounded the bottom corners, just the bottom ones. I didn't want to get the top with the fold. So I rounded the bottom corners with a 1/2 inch corner rounder, and then I applied some Christmas Red Stickles Glitter Glue as sort of like little Christmas balls on each of the Christmas trees, and then went back in and filled it in with Ranger enamel accents in white. Just really added lots of detail to those trees. I think it looked great plain by itself too. So here's a close-up of those trees with the glitter on them and with the enamel accents. And that finishes the card for today. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you on Friday for day 20. Thanks for watching.